In this course, I would like to talk a little bit about the bot design process. I'll be two sides to mention. The first is the client side and the second is the naval engineer. When the customer decides to have a bot built, first decide on main dimensions and type of the bot. This part is decided by the customer. Then by coming the shipbuilding engineer, customer requests to make a bot in desired main dimensions of the type. Then as you can see on the screen in a surface modeling program such as Engineer Rhino or MechSurf, models the hull model in first stage. When modeling this body model in the first stage, actually knows nothing about this body model. I'm assuming you actually manufactured this body model. We took it and threw it in the sea. Where does this hull model float? So, where is the water withdrawal? Where is the water line? In fact, in the beginning, the engineer doesn't know the answer to any of these questions. In the following process, the customer side talked with the engineer and explained what the engineer had done. They determined the minimum and maximum draft range for the boat in line with hydrostatic and stability calculations. Let's draw a water line to show the draft more easily. Line and zero. I draw a horizontal line, then hold green arrow and center it. I extrude it by pressing the red ball. Then let's move that up a bit. Our boat's calculation in MechSurf, its maximum draft was 4 meters. I'm writing 4000 millimeters here. We said that this is the point where the boat should actually float. In fact, this is the point where the boat can sink the most. It can't sink any further. If you are actually building a large boat, this creation is determined supporting because already working with engineers on the customer side. But if you are building a small boat, it's up to you decide where the boat will float. Well, I'm assuming you made such a hull model and threw it overboard. How much will it sink when you throw it into sea? The answer to this question is weight calculation. All the objects from face to weight displays water. Actually, this is the most important point. All floating objects displace water as much as their weight. So actually, what is the weight of this boat? This boat will displace that much water. Then, how do we know the weight of the boat? Actually, from the beginning of the Rhino course, we will proceed by calculation the weight until the end. As I said, actually MechSurf and Rhino interconnected courses. Because MechSurf, we have reached a good point. But to make stability calculations after the point, to calculate the final stability booklet, we couldn't continue, because we didn't know the weight of the boat. The weight of the boat, we will calculate it inside the Rhino course. In the future, everything is modeled in 3 dimensions, and after everything is modeled, the weight calculations is done. We will follow these procedures in order. After calculation the weight, you know how much the boat will sink. So how would you know at the start? You only modeled the body. How do you know how far this boat will sink? Actually, you don't know the answers to that at first. Just where on the boat you want it float, you decide. So I am assuming based on the boat form, this boat sinking 4 meters. Or you said that sinking of 3.5 meters give productive results for this boat. Therefore, you can specify this range as a draft range for the boat. Even after the boat is actually built, will not always sink at the same level. So draft of the water in which it flows will change, because the loading conditions of the tanks may change or the weights in the boat may vary. When any of these two change, in fact the weights and moments are displaced. Automatically when you move, the boat will look less or more than before. So for boats, there is not have a draft value. There is a draft range. Draft range for our boat between 3.5 meters and 4 meters. Now let's stop calculation aside. Secondly, there is an important point that I would like to say. I don't want it to be misunderstood. It is a point that I want to say by emphasizing on it. When you build a boat from scratch, you can't get body model from lines plan. Because no one will come and give you lines plan or anything. Therefore, without using the lines plan, the hull of the boat is directly three-dimensional. We need to model in surface modeling programs. We started with the three-dimensional line plans, because we also know how to model an existing body form. I want you to see, but when you actually have nothing, you can design a boat from scratch. When you start, you haven't lines planned, so the way I followed, you will not be able to. In this case, take the help from program such as MaxSurf or Rhino, you can model. We actually modeled the hull using line plans in the Rhino course. While we have nothing in the beginning phase of the MaxSurf course, we proceeded by modeling the hull of the boat. So, what I'm trying to say is that they are not modeled from lines plan at initial stage. Lines is something that emerge later from the plan. I'm assuming right now using knit comments inside Rhino, I modeled the body you see on this screen. I can create a plan of lines using this body. But if I don't have a three-dimensional body at hand, the lines plan is therefore I can't get it. So the initial step is to model the body in three dimensions. You can create the lines plan later. Using this body model in the next lesson, we will talk about how to create a lines plan. Now, having said part about lines plan, let's quickly repeat the boat design process again. Initially, the client side, coming to the engineer and conveys to main dimensions and the type of the boat he wants to have done to the engineer. Engineer then models boat hull as a designer. After modeling, decides where it wants to swim in the boat. We determined this range as 3.5 meters to 4 meters. Subsequently, within this draft range, that is, it makes the hydrostatic and stability calculations of the boat in the range of the swim line. When hydrostatic and stability calculations are provided, now make sure of the shape of the boat. Can also perform a resistance analysis, CFD analysis of the boat as engineering confident in its form. When performing resistance analysis and CFD analysis, the boat will encounter while sailing at the sea. It detects the amount of resistance. So when he puts a machine of what power in the boat, it actually determines the speed of the boat. After that, things progress up to a certain point. After that, everything is locked, because the weight of the boat is not known exactly. Because as the weight increases, the draft also increases, and as the weight decreases, the draft also decreases. If customer doesn't know exactly the weight of the boat, neither how much the boat will sink, nor does it know in any way how stable the boat will be. Therefore, the part of the process we call sample is completed. After completed the sample part, now we can see Rhino, NupaScat Medic, Aviva, or 3D surface modeling programs. With the help of anyone, models everything in the boat in 3 dimensions. This 3-dimensional body includes main decks, intermediate decks, frames, arts, elements, the table, chair, cabins. Everything that makes weight in the boat has a weight. Everything that happens is superimposed on the 3-dimensional model. Then weight and moment calculation. This ensures that the boat is in balance. After everything is modeled in 3 dimensions, now the weight of the boat is known with certainty. If the weight is precisely known, depending on the loading conditions of the tanks, how much the boat will sink is also obtained with certainty. After this stage, since the engineer knows the weight with certainty, all stability can make the calculations in the final form. Our main purpose for using MaxSurf and Rhino is the path we are following. We have reached a certain point in MaxSurf. We have only gotten to a certain point in the draft range we predicted. We couldn't move forward. The main reason we couldn't move forward was because we didn't know the weight of our boat. It can be attached to boat during the Rhino course. By adding all elements on the boat, we will calculate the weight within Rhino course. Afterwards, we calculate the weight we obtain precisely MaxSurf. We will use it inside the stability module. Therefore, in the MaxSurf stability module, we will have calculated the stability buckle of our boat that can be delivered to the captain. In this course, I want to talk a little bit about the design process. Three-dimensional body. In the next lesson, I want to talk about how to create a lines plan using the model. See you in the next lesson.